It's time for another video, people. Okay, right. We're going to be carrying on with all the bits of stuff that I've got inside that case, okay? Now then. In another video, I'm just getting a couple of things ready. In another video, we went inside that case and we dug out the big bag that was in there, okay? That one. Okay, we got that out of the case, and we went through that and we had a look at what was inside there. And I also said in that video that I also keep a load of other extra pieces in there, and a few homemade bits and pieces as well. And that's what we're going to be looking at today. Not that, but the other bits and pieces that I keep inside that. Okay, let me wind the camera up and we should go over to the kitchen worktop. And yeah, I will surprise you as to the amount of extra bits and pieces you can fit into that little Kewtech bag. Okay, here we go. Pop. There you go, there's all the extra bits and pieces that I fit into that Kewtech bag. Okay, all of that. Some of it's homemade and some of it is, you know, other bits of kit that you can buy. Okay, I'll go through each individual bit and piece. But what I'm going to do is obviously separate that into two piles. Okay, the bits that you can buy straight out of the stockist and the homemade stuff. Okay, so I'm just going to put the camera over there. Okay, and I'm now going to separate them. Okay, so that can go into that pile, as can that, that, and I think that's about it. Okay, the rest of it's homemade, or, you know, I've got bits and pieces and made them up myself. Okay, let's pull that camera back then. Okay, there's the optional extra bits of kit up in front of the camera there. Over to the other side, if I spin the camera around, there's all the homemade stuff. We'll go into that in a bit later, but for now, what we're going to be looking at is the optional extra kit. Okay, that's obviously a bolt stick. I've got a large socket, we can quickly do a test with it. There's a large socket there, offer it up, and there you go. I've got a feeling the batteries are in this flat, because this one, it's supposed to bleep. I don't know if you heard that. I will take the camera off the tripod, okay, and get it right up next to it. It's supposed to do a bleeping sound, but listen to this. Okay, I don't know if you heard that, but there you go. It's also got a little LED light in the front of it as well. I don't know if I can... There you go, can see that? See? It's got a little LED light in the front of it. Not quite sure what you'd want that for, but there we go. It's got one in there anyway. The funny thing about this bolt stick, okay, I actually got that as part of a kit in another tester that I'm going to be showing a little bit later on in the test kit mini series. That bolt stick actually came along with, it's like a bundle, if you know what I mean, but I'll keep that inside that case, okay? Yeah. One thing that made me laugh when I got that out of the case, it's called a Volt Alert. If I can zoom in on it. There you go, Volt Alert. 1AC-A. Okay. And it says on its sensitivity range, 90 volts to 1000 volts AC. Here's the thing that made me laugh. It's actually moulded into the case. I don't know if I'll be able to get on it. But, it says it down there. There you go. Warning. Text. before using. That is before with two R's. Again, I don't know if I'll be able to get on it, but it is something which I want on camera because it's just stupid. There you go. T-E-X-T space B-E-F-O-R-R space U-S-I-N-G. That's what they've wrote into it. Warning, text before using. I mean, you know, what country was that made in? It's stupid. That came as part of a bundle, that, with some other bit of kit. We'll do that some other bit of kit a bit later. Also, what came in that bundle, but I'll keep it inside that Kewtech bag, is that, okay, you can get various different makes of that, and this one's a dialogue. Okay, you plug that in the wall socket. We'll do that in a minute, actually. This one's got a bleeper in it as well. And you get a series of lights come on. Okay. So if the socket that I'm just about to try out is wired properly, we should get two greens and red light should stay turned off. And then you've got various different other sequences on here. That one's a bit worrying, isn't it? Live and earth reverse. Okay, that would be quite frightening, that one, because if someone's wired up a socket and the live conductor and the earth conductor is reversed, should you plug a class 1 appliance in there, you think, well, why is that class 1 appliance not working? The minute you touch that case on that, it could be a kettle, it could be a washing machine, anything with a metal case, the minute you touch that metal case, you're going to get buzzed. Okay, you're going to get, obviously, mains voltage straight up your arm. Okay, so that one could be a little bit frightening. Live and earth reversed. So if I plug that in the light socket, plug this in the socket, and the middle green one lit up, and the red one lit up, I think, oh my goodness, what cowboy wired that one up? Okay, and then the one down the bottom, it says missing neutral. Okay, and it's if we just get a green light in the middle. Okay, there was a sheet that came with this, and I've got a feeling this detects up to, I think it's like 10 or 15 different test conditions. Okay, the one thing that it can't test, and it says it down there, it says this unit will not detect earth and neutral reverse. Okay, this one's got a bleeper in it. You can get these with and without bleepers. Okay. Okay, basically the one without the bleeper is like the super basic version. You can pick them up for like £5.99 or something. Okay, this one's a well-known make, Dialog. Okay, and the part number for that is DL1090. Again, you can buy that just on its own. Okay, just plug it in the wall socket there and let's see if my wall socket is wired up correctly. I've got a feeling it is, but live on camera now, first time I've ever plugged this tester into that socket, we will see if it's wired properly. Okay, here we go, you ready? It gets into your ears after a while. Again, the buzzer version is quite handy to have because you can go and plug that in the socket, right? Go to the consumer unit, and the minute you get the correct circuit, this little device will start buzzing. Okay, not a proper test, but it's one of those things which could help out. Okay, in another video, before I carry on. Those two things were in a bundle with some other piece of test equipment. We will be looking at that other piece of test equipment later on in the series associated with that case and all the bits and pieces that are in it. But in another video, I show this part. Okay, you put your test probes in there, and on the back we've got the three pins for putting in a wall socket. That's fine if you've got a socket to plug it into, but supposing you haven't. Supposing you've got a round pin socket or a British Standard 4343 socket or IEC 309-2, IEC 60309-2, should I say. That obviously won't go in. Okay. I've got this one. Pop. Okay. Again, similar thing. You put your test probes in. But look. This one's got a wire sticking out at the top of it. Okay. You follow the wire around. And pop. Okay. When you buy this. This one is called a Kewtech R2. And the one with the wire on it is called a Kewtech R2FL. Okay, and the FL basically means you get a flying lead with it. And if I turned it around, it's obviously blank on the back. Okay. When you get that, you don't get that plug with it. Okay, it's just bare exposed wires, and then you put a plug of your choice on there. Okay, I've chosen to put that on there, and I'll show you why in a minute. Okay. And this is where we then carry on over to all my homemade stuff over there. And I shall show you why I've chosen to put that on there instead of, say, something like that. Okay. That's the idea of the R2FL. Is you can buy that and then put that plug on there, like that sort of thing. So you can put that in the socket, in the related socket. Put your test probes in there and you can check, do all the various different checks. Okay. But the thing is, BoomBox Deluxe is not stupid. Because what the idea is behind this, is that you buy about 5 or 6 of them. One will have a plug on it like that. Another one will have a plug on it like that. Another one will have, you know, the yellow version of that. And another one will have a three-phase plug on it, so on and so forth. Well, I'm telling you something, people. BoomBox Deluxe is not stupid, okay? I've bought just one. And then put that on the end of it. I'll show you why right now. Because BoomBox Deluxe is not stupid. Okay? This goes over now carries on over to all my homemade pieces of kit there. Okay? Just a couple of random crocodile clips. Again, I'll keep them in that bag. Okay, and that Edison screw on there, it's got a shaver plug on there. You can get your test probes in there if you wanted to and just check the light socket. Okay. So just a couple of random bits floating around there, but I'll keep them in that case. Where's the case? There it is, that grey one that says Kewtech on it. All this stuff I'm showing on the worktop lives inside that case. So like I said, BoomBox Deluxe is not stupid. And, yeah, the idea behind that is to try and get you to buy 5 or 6 of them and then put your various different plugs on the end. Okay, you can get one of those, put that on the end, buy another one of those, put that on the end, so on and so forth. I ain't having it, people. So I've chosen to put that on the end, and here's why. Using that, I can then select, say, for example, that. Okay. Look what's on the other end of the flex. Pop. Yes. If I couple those together, there we go. You've now got one of those with a BSEN 60309-2 plug on the end of it. Yay! You see, it's so easy. BoomBox Deluxe has flavour, people. Okay, that's my idea, so it's copyrighted to BoomBox Deluxe, okay? Now then, this one has got the pins on the back of it. That's alright if, you know, the socket is in an easily accessible place where you can then get your test probes in there to do voltage checks and things. Supposing it's not. Using that one up in front of the camera there, we now decouple that plug. Okay, they are quite firmly connected in there. Take that away. And then get this one. Plug it on there. It will go. They're all interconnected and compatible. And there we go. So we then got that on one end. We put test probes in. And on the other end, yay, you see, we've got a British Standard 1363. Okay, so we can have it like that. Or, if your socket's in an easily accessible location where you can get your test probes in, you can use one like that. Okay? So, if I decouple that, I've yet to make up... where is it? There it is. 15 amp British Standard 546, and there's the socket for it. So that would go in there, like that. Okay, and then the plug would go on there. Okay, so you get the idea. Kewtech are sort of trying to basically pull the wool over your eyes and get you to buy about 5 or 6 of these and then put various different plugs on the end. Well, BoomBox Deluxe is not having it, people. Okay, I've got that one which can go on there. I'm going to make that one up so that can go on there. And I've also got a British Standard 1363 plug with a lead and that on there, which can go on there as well. And I'm going to be making up a few other varieties as well. And it'll have that inter-connecting plug on it. Okay, so all this stuff except that, because that lives in a case on its own, I'm going to show you that all of this stuff goes in that little Kewtech bag. But before we do, there's one bit of kit left, and it's that. Okay, it's got a socket, British Standard 1363 socket, and it's got that on the end. Okay, again, very handy for testing things. Let's say, for example, I've got a British BSEN 60309-2 socket, and I want to do some tests on it. I can put that in the socket, run that all the way down, and we've got that on the end. I can then get that, plug it on there, like so. Okay, so we got that. And I can get this one with the plug pins on the back of it, put it in there, and there we go. I can then get my test probes in there and do a test on the socket, which is to that standard. Okay, so you get the idea. Let's move all that out of the way. Okay, so you get the idea there with that one. BoomBox Deluxe has flavour, people. Okay, so there you go. It's all homemade stuff, this. You get the bits and pieces and then you make it up. Make it up yourself. Okay, so there you go. And then if I want, I can then unplug that off of there. And put that one on if I wanted. Okay, you get the idea. Or, yeah, so on and so forth. Like I say, make it all up yourself. And you save yourself some money, really. Because, like I say, with this R2FL, Kewtech are trying to pull the wool over your eyes and get you to buy about 5 or 6 of these. And... put various different plugs on the end. I've got a feeling these are about 22 quid a pop. Okay, it's cheaper to do that with it. And then you can couple on your own plugs and bits. Okay. Can you just excuse me a minute, people? I've got a feeling Toby's at the kitchen window. Here he is. Toby! Do you want to come in, my tubby ass? I think he wants to come in, people. Right. I'm just going to put that there. Toby wishes to come in. If you just bear with me a minute, people. Come on, tubby ass. Bring your balls in. Here we go. Right then. So that covers all of that. Okay, here comes the Tobias. Here he is. I think he wants nibbles. But he's going to have to wait a minute. Because I'm going to now show you that all of that stuff goes in that little Kewtech bag. Okay. So there's our Kewtech bag. I'm going to show you that all of that stuff does go in that bag. and fit in the case. Okay, so there's our, again, this, what's in there at the minute, that is, you can buy that with the part number called ACC kit 1. But I'm going to put all my optional extra bits of kit in there as well, because it's got all the various different, well, if I take that out, you've got, so you've got straps there, so you can put your optional extra stuff in, and that's what I'm going to do right now. Yeah. So first of all then, what I'm going to do is that there, I'm going to flip that around the other way, like that. Remember that? That then plugs on there like that. There you go, that's in there. Okay, then I'm going to get this one, fold that underneath there like so. There's a certain way all this stuff goes in this pouch. Put that around there. There you go, that's in there. There's a lead that goes around with the plug, socket on it, and spare plug, or whatever, which way round it is. That goes in there as well, under that strap. You see, it's all going in there. That doesn't belong in there. That's just sits in the case on its own. That can go just down the side there, like so. How does this go in there? I know this goes in there somehow. I think I'll just put the plug in the middle like that, and then bring the lead all the way round, something like that. I know all this does fit in there. It's amazing, but it does all fit in there, something like that. Anyway, it goes all the way round. I do manage to get all of this in there. There we go, that's it. Again, I had to dig all this out to do the other video to show that just the ACC kit one on its own. 15 amp plug, the British Standard 546, that lives just there. Other volt stick goes in the pouch there, over the back. That goes in the pouch as well. Two crocodile clips. Like so. Okay, you can see it all going in. And then just finally, our little bag of light mates go in there, like so. Close it up, zip it up. And there you go, it's all in there. Let me move that camera back. See, no, all the parts are gone. That little bag has consumed it, and if I open the case up, there we go. There's the slot there for the Kewtech bag. In it goes, like so. It does help if I put that end in with a strap first. Like so, there we go. And when we close the case, do that up. Like so, everything's in the case, people. Okay. So, that was it for 23 minutes and, 23 and a few seconds. So, a little bit later on, we should be diving back into that case and we should be getting a bit more test equipment out, having a look around all of that. But for now, Toby wants his nibbles and we'll carry on with that a bit later. So, for 24 minutes, thanks for watching, people.